had a great camp. He had 100% camp with no injury. Great sparring, great, no bruises. Everything went perfect as planned. We ready, bro. All we doing right now is, you know, letting you guys get the last feedback off that. You know, get the energy off you guys, suck it up. It's Saturday night, brother, and you, bro. Yeah. Still, I mean, you again, well, I'm going to say again because Danny going to be champion again. I'm not going to say you, but he was champion again.
So what's going on with the hit mask?
With the what?
The hit mask.
Oh, yeah, well, the hit came about. Because I seen the video on Instagram.
Yeah.
When Moses getting on board. But the thing is this, bro. You know what that makes me think? That their camp is confused. Their camp is confused. Meaning is why you need, there's too many captains and no Indians. Too many captains, no Indians. You only need one Indian. You only need one chief. Not five chief, because too many voices. Confusing. You train somebody one way, he trained too much shit going on their camp. That makes me think something ain't right over here. But I don't give a shit, but I'm not worried about that. It's not my business.
Hold on, hold on, hold on.
That's why it came about the it and the bozo. I don't know how you looked at it. Did you laugh about it? You didn't laugh about it? Oh, you're right. I mean, you want to stay neutral. I'm not taking sides.
I didn't laugh at it.
What they were doing.
But he said he was giving him different looks to get so he could match.
That was a joke for history. That was a joke.
Do you think it was a wild
Danny choice? Danny do not fight like that. People think that Danny comes wild like that, but when you're in there, it's a totally different shit. You gotta look at all Danny fight, where all the guys are at.
What's the one thing?
Done. He's tired.
What's the one thing
Danny?
He
said, Thurman will never fight again. Thurman will never fight again.
Because Danny broke
his head. Broke his head. That's a bad injury he had. He got a right hand where he's throwing and he's snapped. It's broken here. That's a real serious, it's after having a shoulder injury. When you snap your shoulder off, softballs get that a lot. Because trainers don't know how to throw a hook on the softball, you gotta turn your right hand. They have him turning like right hand. Like when they snap their shoulder.
Like a pitcher.
No, it's like, yeah, it's like when you get, it's like the Eagles quarterback. I'm not gonna put him down. Why you think he ain't starting? But he got a real serious injury in his kneecap. I'm not gonna put him down because I don't know what the doctor would be.
We're bringing Shane in the camp. What do you think about that? You think that's possible?
Man, listen. Shane, who he trained? His son is 10-2. He just won the contender, I think.
Okay.
I think.
Yeah.
I'm not putting him down. I'm just saying. Why his son ain't a champ? Just because you're a fighter, you need to be a trainer. Look, the best trainers in the world never did the sport. They did either boxing, either football, basketball. The best trainers in college. They never played college ball, bro. That's a gift. You gotta be given. It gotta be given to you. It's a gift. It's a knowledge. It's a wisdom. They're giving to you from the big man to the little man. Big man, the man up there. We only fear him. That's all we fear.
So you
I don't change nothing, bro. It's not broken. What you fixing is broken, then you gotta fix it.
So you find him bringing a chain in the ring?
I'm fine. Not disrespectful. Not disrespectful to me.
Yeah.
I don't know. To his father, probably. Because if I bring somebody in my camp, it's making me look like I'm lower than him. Why? Why? You ain't bigger than me. I know much as you. That's the guy that got no will. They don't got no confidence. I look at another man, like he got him. No, he wants to look like God. Get on your knees and say, God, give me knowledge, wisdom. I want to go to another level. It's a level every time. This and a notch, and then another notch. And then another. It takes a guy to take you to a far life, then it can't step the next notch.
So
when you need help.
When did you know you're suffering in this camp?
We never do nothing.
Nothing's
not broken.
From the Rios
nothing
camp.
Broken. Well, we don't know. What's the change?
Anything different from the sermon?
I mean, they do not tell who's hurt.
Yeah.
That fight was politics against me in New York City. Not you guys, not New York person. But the commission, it was politics. They used me like a guinea pig. They called me racist. They fucked my head. Today would have been something like this. It wasn't what it is today. It was like, shh, don't talk, don't talk. I couldn't even do anything because they were calling me racist. I lived through that shit. What got me mad was I lived through racism. My mom was taught to shut up in the bus stop because she couldn't speak Spanish back then. When Latinos were little in the country. When Telemundo was a little room, now it's a major TV, everybody want to make business with us. Everybody /NBC/Telemundo now. When I was a little kid, Telemundo was a little room. And nobody wanted to work with them. Calling me race, I lived through that shit. So I felt violated because I lived through that. I was called a spink in the middle of the street, shut up, spink. And I was, behind lunches in school when there was 15 kids in the class because my mom couldn't fill out the form. And I sparred in school. Come on, man. Bullshit.
If Danny beats,
I live through that shit.
If Danny beats or when Danny beats Sean Porter, what's next on the agenda?
Whoever. You're not running for nobody. Listen. I said it before and I'm saying it. We only fear God, brother. We don't fear no man like myself. You could be 6 feet tall, you could be 3 feet tall. If you're a man, you deserve to get smacked, you get smacked. And if you deserve to get kicked in the balls, because you're too tall, you're going to get kicked in the balls. Because I've grown guys like that, big guy down, right in the ball eyes. Right in there, whoo, you know where. Yes. What I mean by that is I'm not a tough guy, I'm a humble guy. I respect everybody, I don't judge nobody. I respect everybody, but the thing I'm trying to say is I only fear God. I don't fear no other man like myself.
Does Danny have the same mindset
anymore? Yeah, I raised him over there. We've been over that hump years ago when Danny was 10. When I grabbed him in the ringside, I gripped him and I threw him across the room. Because he lost to a guy he should have beat in the amateurs. And I was so mad at him, he's running around eating hot dogs on him. And I don't feel happy about it, but I bust my ass from 9-9 until you travel. Because boxing get the end of the stick with kids in the boxing world. Boxing get no support. You guys give it love, so I appreciate you guys. But boxing don't get like every other sport. They have a channel that runs through the whole 24 hours a day. And every time an American fighter get on TV, he's considered, oh, he threw a, did you see the right hand? Ah, it's okay. But did you see the other guy? Wow, look at his big right hand. Did you ever see that in your life? Never seen a guy stuffing like that. No, you seen that, buddy. It's all bullshit sometimes. And that's what happened in the tournament. It's a lot of bullshit. A lot of bullshit put me up mentally, because I'm prepared for a fight like Danny. I can't have bullshit going on that week. Like today, I can't have bullshit on my mind.
Outside the ring.
They don't got nothing to do with me. If it ain't life threatening to my family, then it's okay with me. But you can't have me and all this bullshit calling me racist. People don't know what I went through that week. I couldn't even talk in the ring. I would look back at the fight now and say, damn, I could have just told Danny this little more. I was like frozen. I couldn't talk. It was like I was stuck, like my brain was fucked up. Like
I'm comfortable with the way things are now.
Yeah, everything's perfect. I want to let them get to me now.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to say the dumb shit like I did. No, okay. I didn't say nothing bad. Yeah. He said, I'm going to fuck you up, Danny Garcia.
Yeah.
And we went first. So first of all, Danny went wrong with that car.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go back. Like, we
got
to worry about Porter.
Gotcha.
I just want to correct a little bit of facts.
The bitch ass.
Yeah, I want to correct the little bit about the past that people didn't know. We went first. The reason why it was Thurman Garcia, because Danny chose that.
Okay.
And I said, Danny, I think it's a bad idea for you to give up your name.
Are you talking about the title of the fight?
The name on the card.
Gotcha.
Like Garcia versus Porter.
So you actually make a choice.
It was Garcia versus Thurman, but gotcha. Danny chose to give up his name. I said, Danny, in the boxing world, you never give up your name, but that's the A-side.
Okay.
Meaning is this, if the fight is close, the rebel usually you're going to give it to the A-side. That's why Thurman got it.
Okay.
Because that fight, Thurman could have did more, we could have did more. We both could have did more. But the round that they gave Thurman, Danny won the round because Thurman ran through it. I think he was already hurt in the tent. Because I kept seeing him buckling it like that, and I was like, damn, something wrong with him. I couldn't figure it out.
Okay.
Danny would have progressed, he probably would have stopped it. But the thing was, that's the past. We can't check, but we learned from that.
Yeah.
But when it came down the line, they gave us a fight. One point was the 11th round. You look at the 11th round, we won that round. With eyes closed.
Yeah.
So why he didn't? Because the judge that gave him the round was a WBA judge.
Now this time around, since you had that situation, the fight was
not
close. Are you going to make the fight close this round?
We're not winning that night. The thing I'm trying to say to you was, it wasn't that I let the fight get close. It was because the bullshit that went down the pipe that week. I was mentally drained, mentally. Listen, brother, the shit I went through, you don't want to go through.
Porter's
okay. Now, let me ask.
Go ahead.
Good. Now, with all due respect to what you've been through in terms of racism.
That's the past.
Now, let me ask you this. I'm going to play devil's advocate for a minute. When you talk about a non-Puerto Rican athlete, you make a racial slur, which will imply that you're a racist.
Yeah, but
can you answer the Amir Khan versus Zab?
Well, that was different.
So
that
on
was,
and so forth.
That was something, what I usually do, well, I don't want to give my seat. But what happens is, I say everything that came out of your voice.
Mm-hmm.
I just repeated what you said. So I didn't say no race, I just talk what you said. And the flying carpet has a flying carpet. They use that in the kids' cartoons all the time.
Terrence Crawford, nappy-headed ho. Nappy-headed ho, Terrence Crawford. You know what I'm talking about?
What I said?
Nappy-headed ho.
Well, no. The thing is, if you got nappy hair, you got nappy hair. But no, wrong with that.
The implications of it, though. I'm talking about like, people who hear it.
Well, but the people did listen to things differently. Mm-hmm. Everybody listens differently. Everybody, if I give you a message, you might listen to it differently. That's why God worked through voices. Because God worked through voices. God worked, I might say something to you, but he heard it differently. It woke him up. I just helped him how to become a better man.
What did God say to Danny for this fight? Huh? What did God say to Danny for this
fight?
Go
fuck him up. We ain't gonna let nine under the table. We ain't gonna leave nine on cover. Where were you going out there from round one? We winning every round. We not putting none nobody's hand.
If it wasn't for boxing, where would y'all be at?
Boxing, we'd probably be in the porno business.
What you gotta say to Kenny Porter? He was looking for you. Did you see the skit that they did?
Nah.
At the market? Oh, it was a skit with a comedian, Ha Ha Davis. Did you see that?
Nah,
you missed it. Okay.
I'll probably see it.
Okay, you'll see it later. Yeah.